Thank you for joining me for another edition of the Bob Sullivan Show. Today I have on with me local JJ. How you doing today, JJ?
Pretty good, Bob. Pretty good. Glad to be on the show. Big fan.
Big fan?
Big fan of the show.
What's your favorite part of the show so far?
Oh, I mean, it's tough to pick a favorite, but you got some good guests.
Yeah, it's... I mean, when you have to pick, it's almost like Sophie's Choice. you know what that movie is, right?
Yeah, I'm aware of that movie.
Okay, good. You are a, just for the listeners out there, JJ is a former Omaha Royal intern, unpaid intern, is that correct?
It was unpaid intern, so a little bit of both.
And also, you were a member of the Albuquerque Isotopes at one point,
yes,
too.
That was a paid job, yes. That was a paid job, Albuquerque Isotopes Baseball Club.
How was that for you?
Well, that was exciting. Albuquerque, New Mexico is the mecca of excitement. Never a dull moment, so.
How nostalgic was it when the storm chasers came to Albuquerque for the classic PCL championship? Or the it would have been the championship against the
national championship.
That's right.
Yeah, PCL against internationally, and I guess it was like my life coming full circle. It all came together in one game, you know.
did you get to talk any trash before the game with any of your former colleagues, or was it pretty business as usual for JJ?
It was pretty clean. I let the action on the field do talking. It was pretty clean.
Well, what are you doing now? Are you still looking for a paid job for sports, or what are you looking for here?
You know, I'm in a transition period right now. I got me a full-time job in Omaha. I'm liking that, but if anyone does have any sports offerings out there, I'm always up to hear that. Not quite done with sports yet, but yeah.
What is the daily grind like for a... what was your daily grind in Albuquerque and Omaha for the Royals?
Oh. Boy, good question, Bob.
Thank you.
Albuquerque, a little easier than Omaha. Omaha was about 8:45 report time, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock report time on Saturdays. And then obviously you work till the end of the game. We were there for quite a bit, over 12 hours.
Yeah.
The offices in Omaha weren't quite as nice, and so, there's a problem there. Albuquerque, usually show up about 10 o'clock in the morning and leave, up 11.
Yeah.
Saturday, we didn't have to show up till about 2 o'clock, and that's where I talked to you, but Albuquerque was pretty easy, still 12-hour days, though, good deal.
Well, how did it... How was it when you went from being everybody else's bitch to finally having some bitches to work under you?
I was still pretty big. I was still a bitch in Albuquerque. I do some bitch work.
That's not something that's easy to admit.
Yeah, I had to kind of accept that. I had to accept that. But I did have a little more responsibility. I could boss some people around and, I took advantage of that, And my second year in Omaha, it's more privileges too. I was kind of running the little unpaid interns around and telling them what to do. So my last 2 years, I was bossing people around left and right.
That's good. Did you ever get to dress up as Casey?
Yes.
What was the worst experience for you dressing up as Casey?
One time, the regular guy got sick, and I had to fill in at the Gretna Day Parade when it was 102 degrees out.
Did you ever get racked by any kids? You did.
You have to be on the lookout for that. They like the kids like Rocky and JC.
What's the reason for that? What's the number one reason for racking Casey? Does the spike get racked as much?
Blue line. It's pretty simple there. I mean, 14-year-old isn't going to want to rack a blue line and then Joe Nads.
All right. Well, you are competing with the legend J.J. Davis for local supremacy here. What do you got to burn on today about local sports? I assume Creighton Blue Jays would be public enemy number one for you right now.
I got a couple burns right now, but yeah, Creighton's at the top of my list. They really hit a roadblock that I don't even know anymore. I expected Northern Iowa, and it was a little shock to me, but not showing up for the biggest game of the year, it's kind of unexcusable.
Do you think they're just tired out, or what do you think?
I think it's a mixture of things. I think tired out, and they're not hitting their shots like they were at the beginning of the year, and honestly, their shots aren't going down. They don't know what to do. They seem a little confused at their times.
Do you think, what's his name, Doug's been, figured out how to, the Valley's kind of figured out that as long as you don't give him his putbacks and whatnot, because that's really been the thing that's been overlooked with him is his game is pretty comparable to Kevin Love, where a lot of his points come off of garbage plays. He doesn't create for himself, so that limits his scoring opportunities. And if you limit his offensive rebounding, you really can limit his game. Do you think that's been a major factor that's overlooked right now?
Yes and no. I mean, also, it's not like he's not exactly been lightened up. I mean, he still has, he still had, 20-something points a few nights ago. He's not exactly, he's not getting 40 points anymore, but he's definitely, he's not slacking, I would say. But, yesterday was a tough day to watch for him. Wichita State had him figured out pretty good.
I'm worried that they could get bounced in the second round by Missouri State if Missouri gets the three.
They can get bounced in the second round by Missouri State or you and I. I think if they take care of business the rest of the way, win out, get the two seed, and get the Sunday they're in.
Yeah.
But
they definitely can't lose on Saturday in St. Louis now. Saturday in St. Louis is one of the biggest games of the year right now. What do you think they're the highest seed they can get in the? I'm not asking what Joe Lenardi says. I'm asking what you think their highest.
8 or 9.
You think that's the highest they can go?
8 or 9. Maybe 7, but I'm thinking 8 or 9.
I think that's the best. 7. I mean, if any year.
Win the tournament, if they beat Wichita State and win the tournament, I would maybe say 7.
Well, I'd say that 7 through 9 would be their best bet. And the reason I say that is, for them to get a win, is because I don't like the matchup of if they were to get a 5 seed, which is not going to happen anymore, which was originally projected. But if they were to get a 5 or a 4 seed, they would get like a mid-major team that maybe came on strong at the end, and that would smell disaster, almost like in Nevada type situation. But if they get a 7 or 9. A 7, 8, 9, they could get a low-level Big East, a low-level Big 12, or hopefully if Nebraska were to win the Big, actually, Nebraska would probably be a 16 Big 10 title. But where do you think they're what do you think a team that they could upset that's a 1 or 2 seed if they were to get a 7 or 8?
Oh, I mean, that's a good question. A 1 or 2 seed that they could upset. Maybe a KU type team.
KU?
I'm not sure. KU doesn't have a lot of size. They have some size, but it's not like a Sellinger or a Fab Mello.
Yeah.
And if KU, we've seen that if KU goes cold, they're kind of like great North. They only throw shots. They're not going to win the game. They lost to Davidson, so we've seen that before.
And Bradley.
And Bradley.
And Bucknell.
Well, they lost to Davidson this year, though, already.
Oh, I thought you meant, like, in...
They lost to Davidson this year, so...
Yeah. Do you think that... do you think this team is, for next year, the one thing, I mean, everybody says, all they're losing is Antoine Young. And I think it's possible that, I mean, I don't think it's out of the question that Gregory doesn't come back. He might just go down to Venezuela. I mean, he graduates this year. He could go down to Venezuela and play on their national team. Of course, let's not forget they're losing Dorwart and Sebastian. Those are two huge losses. What do you think their outlook for? Do you think they're how much better do you think this team is next year? And who do you think the key would be to that? I don't see Doug going pro at all.
No, Doug won't go pro. I would say next year is definitely going to be, a better year. It depends on how much Chapman matures.
Yeah. He's incredible the way he can penetrate. Like, I was expecting this kind of... Like, his game is what I expected from Antoine all along. I mean, it's a lot more raw, but I thought Antoine could have been that slasher that Austin Chapman showed that he is against Drake. And Dingman can start, could be a huge factor next year because his, as long as he's more athletic than people give him credit for. And he is capable of getting to the basket. He's been limited shooting-wise. Their best bet is to put him on the perimeter or put him out there with Rogge because all the attention goes to Rogge, and then he's left open instead of being the lone shooter on the floor, which he can't seem to handle. What do you think Dingman makes a huge impact next year, or do you think he's he can even make an impact in St. Louis?
I think Dingman could make an impact in St. Louis, if he comes in and hits his shots. Kind of maybe a little bit of a liability on defense, but...
But who isn't?
Yeah, who isn't on this team?
What's the best... Who's the sleeper team, do you think, in the Valley tournament to come alive and win the... conference tournament this year?
Anyone outside of Wichita and Creighton is going to be a sleeper. I'd probably say MSU and UNI.
Okay. I was surprised by the step back that Missouri State took this year as far as their potential. I mean, Weems has played the way he has his entire career, but even for him, he's not the type of player that can just, he can dominate against Creighton, but he can't really take over and be he can't do all the scoring like, for example, Doug did for a while. Do you think that's the, most dangerous team outside of Creighton and Wichita.
Yeah, I'd have to agree there.
All right, local sports-wise, we'll get back more into this. What do you got? What are you most into right now outside of Creighton?
Yeah, Creighton baseball starting up here pretty soon. You know, the Storm Chasers will be getting going here fairly quickly. Yeah, a couple other things getting ready to go. Lancers having a pretty good year.
Yeah.
So, a couple good things going on right now. I'd probably say getting ready for college baseball would be my next biggest thing.
Who's the player to watch for Creighton right now, this year for baseball?
Yeah, that's a good question. I'm not quite sure yet. It's gonna be interesting.
Do you know any players on their baseball team right now?
I know a few still. You know, and they're very heavy on the pitching. Pitching's gonna be their mainstay this year. And pitching and defense will be their two big things you gotta watch for Creighton.
Who would you go to in a situation with, Storm Chasers versus, or a Creighton game? Which one would you rather go to?
That's a good question. I don't know. Probably would depend on the night and who's playing.
God damn it, JJ. What's the outlook? Is Omaha Nighthawks, are they coming back or are they done?
I would think they'd be done. But the UFL has surprised me before, so.
Well, do you think they get out of their problem of not making any money anytime soon, or are they gonna keep wiping their asses with $100 bills that they don't have?
I think that the UFL is gonna have to make some changes to make some money. I think that's gonna be the big deal. Gotta make some changes to make some money.
Do you? I've been crying for this for years. I want a D League team in Omaha.
I would love a D-League team in Omaha. Yeah, I mean, you're forgetting you're talking to a former Omaha racer, ball boy, and season ticket holder.
Well, I was a member of the fan. I was a fan of the Omaha Racers. Rhodey was the greatest mascot.
The best minor league mascot in Omaha.
And they also, do you remember the games of the, what was it, the mascot games that they used to have there?
The mascot games were Rhodey's birthday party, what the official title was.
Oh, that's right. Was there a better place to watch minor league sports than the old Exarban Arena? Like,
no, it summed up what the CBA is.
Well, I miss the quarter points.
You know, and I wish the NBA would have adopted that rule, because I think that's one of the best rules you could have.
I mean, the NBA needs to adopt the rule that the D League has with the, you can, if you're the number one seed, you get to pick your opponent in the first round.
You know, there are a lot of,
and then the
rules that,
oh, and then the quarter points rules.
If the NBA picked up on some D League rules, it would improve the product amazingly.
Who is, are you a Mavs follower? Mav Mojo?
I keep up on them.
What's going on there? Where are they standing right now?
They're having a pretty good year. Trying to follow them. They're in the middle of the pack. Have some disappointing losses. Have some surprising wins. But I think they're making a bid to get up to St. Paul for the WCHA tournament.
Do they have a shot at the Frozen Four, or are they not going to come close to that this year?
They're not going to come close.
Right. Any shot at the national tournament?
They have to win the WCHA tournament. They have a good shot at making the top five of the WCHA, so.
Who is...
interesting.
As far as football goes, Yamal Beef.
Uh-huh.
Back for, I think this is their going on a 13th or 14th season, maybe?
They've been around.
They're moving to the new arena in, what's it, in...
Ralston,
right. How great an idea is that arena? That thing is going to be sweet. I'm looking forward to that, because that's Cracker Box for UNO basketball, for Lancer hockey, and the Beef. I mean, it's really, everybody's going to bitch and moan that there's a new arena, but it's only 4,000 seats. You're going to have, there's stuff to do around that area. I mean, you can go to Horseman's and then head up there, or go to a game and afterwards go to Horseman's. I mean, I think there's a strong following in Sarpy County of those teams. Who's the team that's going to most benefit from that move?
Oh, I'd probably say UNO basketball, just because they're going to have a brand new arena. They're going to be able to get their name out there. They're gonna have a tough time winning some games, but you know, they're going to be getting more than the 500 they get at the SAP Fieldhouse.
Well, that place is a dump. I wish they would have played their home games at the Civic this year. I think that could have actually done pretty well.
It would have been interesting, that's for sure.
It would have been, and they could have done that hockey night in Omaha with the basketball night in Omaha, where they have UNO and Creighton, mm-hmm. and shuttle all the senior citizens down to the Quest Center after the game to go watch Creighton. I mean, I think they should have done a double whammy with that, but that's too outside the box thinking for Omaha right now. Where would you put, what do you think's more likely to happen? Doc Sadler gets fired, or the new Nicolas Cage movie makes over $100 million in theaters?
I'd probably have to go Scott Sadler gets fired.
Do you think it's a lock that he does?
It's a lock. It's a good question about the lock.
What kind of money would you put on that he doesn't get another year?
He does not get another year. Right now, I'd bet the house.
You'd bet the house?
I would probably bet the house. They are terrible. They're worse than bad.
I don't get it. I mean, well, I do get it, but I don't get why people still are trying to convince themselves that he's a good coach. I just don't. I hear it from Nebraska fans. Well, it's, he just hasn't gotten his players in there yet. Well, when is he? I mean, this is his sixth year. How long does it take you to get your players in there? And what kind of players is he trying to recruit? Because right now he's recruiting garbage. Bo Spencer is the worst player that gets more credit for being a good player that I have seen in a while. Do you agree or disagree?
I agree.
What do you think the fix is? Where do you think they should go if they're... where do you think the biggest difference is that they could make in changing coaches? Who should they go after? That would be realistically take a job.
I think you're going to have to go... Well, I mean, someone's going to want to take the job, and I think you're going to have to go after some young assistant coach at a BCS program.
Okay. do you what are your predictions for the I want prediction for Creighton for the rest of the season. What's the what do they do in the Valley the rest of the way in the Valley regular season? And
I think they get to Sunday, lose Sunday, and then I think they win one game in the NCAA tournament and then lose in the second round.
What seed do you think they get in the second?
I'm gonna say they get an 8 seed.
8 seed. How many games does Nebraska win the rest of the season? And keep in mind they don't get a bracket buster team, even though they should.
Two.
They win two more.
They win two more games.
Iowa and who? Minnesota on the road. Or
I
Illinois.
Iowa, maybe one. I want to say Iowa. So I don't know what the Big Ten tournament format is.
Do you think?
I was gonna say if they have to play like an Iowa or Penn State or Northwestern in the Big Ten tournament, maybe pick up a win there. But I must say they beat Iowa at home. They have Northwestern, don't they?
No, the Big Ten's weird. They don't do the legends and leaders or something in the Big Ten.
Yeah.
But
maybe just one more win them.
They do get Illinois at home, and Bruce Weber is an
Bruce
awful
Weber
coach.
Way out also. I must say two.
Okay. Where does the Lancers finish? Do they win the cup this year? Bring back the cup to Omaha?
Win their division and get knocked out. Well, I don't know by who, but I think they'll win their division.
And where does the UFL prediction for the Omaha Nighthawks? Do they have a season next year? Does Drew Peterson have a job next year? Does Drew Peterson have a job next year? No?
No.
And also, the beef. Do they win it? Do they win it all this year in their last year at the Civic? No?
No, they do not. No, they have a winning season. They make the playoffs, but they don't win it all.
Damn it. And do the Vipers come back in 2013?
I'm gonna say no on that one.
God damn it! No, that can't happen. The Vipers have to come back.
You were a big Vipers fan, were you?
I was a huge Vipers fan.
If the Vipers come back,
will you go to the first game back? Huh?
They don't like to pay their rent.
Well, that wasn't I don't want to get into the detail, the legalities of the Omaha Vipers, but. Do you think there's any shot that you will go to a game with me of the Omaha Vipers if they make a comeback? The first game back, will you go to a game with me?
If they make a comeback, I will go to opening night with you.
Okay, good stuff. We'll have to do that. Anything else you want to talk about before we hit the...
Let's do this again sometime. I have fun. Let's do this again
sometime. We got to get a format going for this one. We got to figure out a better nickname than Local JJ.
Yeah, that's got to change. That's on you.
I'll have to come up with the creativity there. I'd like a little bit more energy out of you next time too, JJ.
I'm trying, Bob.
You're really phoning it in on me here.
I'm just getting used to the program type and, you know, what you're expecting out of me.
What am I expecting out of you?
I'm getting used to the whole program. This is a new program for me, but I enjoyed it.
Well, I enjoyed having you, and we'll definitely have to do this again sometime. We'll talk some.
Sure.
We'll celebrate the comeback of the Vipers. Hopefully, the comeback of the Racers. And
if the Racers come back, I'm applying for my ball boy position back.
Well, they need to.
Yeah, that's a guarantee. I, you know, he's coaching the WNBA right now, and he's doing a fine job.
Yeah, with the Connecticut Sun. You're doing a hell of a job up there.
The Connecticut Sun are my favorite WNBA team of all time.
No. We're the WNBA's best team is the New York Liberty, my friend.
I'm gonna have to disagree with you there. I think the Sun have
them. Rebecca Lobo, Kim Hampton, friend of the show, by the way, definitely beats out whatever the Connecticut Sun have out there right now. They're just garbage, and you're just gonna have to learn how to deal with that. We could bring Tebow to Omaha if we got Coach T back.
We could bring some Tebowing in Omaha. Tebow was Tebowing before Tebow was...
Before he was circumcising children in
yes.
India or wherever he was.
Yes, so. Agreed.
All right, JJ, well, this is fun doing this. We'll have to do this again next time.
I'll bring some more energy.
Well, you bring some more energy. We might have to do it over a couple of brews to loosen the atmosphere a little bit. And we'll make this happen again. We'll get another local checkup with JJ.
Sounds good to me. I'm excited.
We'll check through the annals of Omaha sports history with JJ's daily breakdown.
I like that. That's good to me.
All right, JJ. Well, thanks for coming on, buddy. Have a good one, buddy.
Yeah, no problem. All right.
Thank you for joining me for that edition of the Bob Sullivan Show. Check out any episodes you may have missed on the YouTube page.